Good evening. May I have your attention, please? We'll be beginning the ceremony shortly. If you could remember to please turn off or put your cell phones on vibrate so that we do not have any distractions or take away from the ceremony. So if you could do that right now, please.
I know the students don't have any cell phones.
No.
Oh. All right.
Good evening. My name is Bud Markowick. I'm principal of Wayne Hills High School, and I welcome you to our scholarships and honors and our awards program for the class of 2007. It's a very special class. There's been a lot of three-peats in our school. I know our football team, we've had tremendous success there, but I learned to that Newsweek magazine for the third consecutive year gave us a three-peat of sorts as the third consecutive year as one of America's best high schools, which puts us in about the top 5% of all public high schools and academies in the nation. So we're very proud of that. More so, I'm very proud of the students, that especially the senior class, because you need senior leadership. And I think that this senior class provided leadership. They grew over the years, and their behavior should be emulated, their achievement should be emulated. They were role models for our underclassmen. So these are some of the seniors in that class, about 100, who will be recognized tonight. Whether they're doing the service auction, or whether they're in the Honor Society, or they're taking another task, we've kind of let the kids go this year, and depended on the students to organize many events. And they responded in such a great manner. When I think of this class, I'll think about things like the Relay for Life. The American Red Cross called us, and it was a concept. And up here tonight, just some of the people that helped the American Red Cross, their representatives and their front people told me the kids took over the operation and ran the show and raised $50,000 this past weekend for the American Cancer Society. And it is the American Cancer Society. Of the people, please hold your applause to the end, were Eric White, Vanessa Roman, Ricky Katz, Jason Ketchator, David Freifeld, Spencer Ferdy, John Moriarty, and Nicole Locantour. So those were your senior leadership that took over that show and really did a wonderful job. So thank you, especially to that group. Tonight, we're going to try to get this program in about 2 hours. We might go to 2 hours and 15 minutes. So we ask for your patience. With 100 students receiving awards, we think that is very indicative of our class, but also the support that we have of our community and our parents. To start things, I'd like to say that John Maxwell wrote The Success Journey, and this was a writing, a motivational writing and a personal improvement writing that put success in a journey to success in perspective for people in all walks of life. Maxwell said that people who reach their potential think in terms of improvement. Furthermore, successful people follow the path of continuous improvement. And I think that tonight you're going to see students that not only have made great strides and are receiving awards for their achievements, but I think in the future will continue to make those strides. So they're people that make things happen. And I always have a short message because I want the program to start, but I will take the message from John Maxwell tonight about making things happen. And he says that millionaire philanthropist Andrew Carnegie said, "As I grow older, I pay less attention to what men say. I just watch what they do. I found that to be sound advice. And as I've watched what people do. I've discovered the ones that I want with me are people who make things happen. These people discover resources and places you thought were barren. They find prospects where you believed there weren't any. They create opportunities where you thought none existed. They take something average and make it exceptional. They never make excuses. They always find a way to make things happen. That audience describes the seniors in front of us tonight. So let me congratulate them, and we will begin our program by recognizing some of the people in this district that make education possible at this level. With us tonight, we have Dr. Maria Nusatelli, Superintendent of Schools. We have Mr. Frank Mobilio, Director of Secondary Education. Frank is back there. Okay, we also have us Mrs. Virginia Marr, our Supervisor of Guidance, who put this program together. We also have Mrs. Karen Hershaft, who is a Board of Education member. Our department chair people who are on the front line working with our teachers day after day to facilitate our academic program. We have Dr. Anthony DeFina, science. We have Mrs. Judith Failey, applied technology. Mr. Benjamin Greekin, Greco, world studies. Excuse me, I'm ahead of myself. He also does world language. Mr. Edward Zambrano, math. A special thank you to Ed, who, besides being a Middle States coordinator, which we just passed our 2.5-year review and did very well. We're making a few adjustments, but we're right on line with our Middle States. Ed also was the acting math department chair for the entire year. And he also was the chair of the Scholarship and Honors Board and put together the entire program, not only for here, but also the scholarships for Wayne Valley as well. So a special thank you to Ed Zambrano. We have Mrs. Angela Mancinelli. Angela? Let's see if she is here. We have our finally Performing Arts Physical Education Chair, Ms. Maureen Weir. Okay. Our guidance counselors present tonight, who provide such great services and direction for our students, we have Mrs. Seal DeGeorge. We have Mrs. Cynthia Gorkowski. And we have Mr. Bruce Keough. Okay. Also joining us, she just did come in from the central office, Assistant Superintendent, Mrs. Cynthia Randina. Thank you, Cynthia. The voting members of the Scholarship and Honors Board, as I said, Mr. Zambrano is chairperson, he doesn't vote. We have Mrs. Carla Fattel, Mr. Dan Fishbane, Mrs. Karen Gross, the Reverend David Harwood, Mr. Doug Lehman, Mr. Charles Maeda, Ms. Susan Negler, the Reverend Karen Ratcliffe, Mr. Michael Ruick, Ms. Debbie Riccardi, and Ms. Sue Sikorsky. And those are the people that review all the applications and make the decisions as to the recipients of the awards. I would like to, at this time, for our opening remarks, call up our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Maria Nusatelli.
Thank you, Mr. Markowitz. Good evening, students. And I know I'm between you and the award, so I'll make this very brief. good evening to the proud parents and family that are here this evening. It's a pleasure to be here this evening to celebrate your achievements. We thank you for making this special evening possible for us and for your parents. Your hard work resulting in these awesome achievements are a source of pride for parents and teachers. You represent the best of the best in your class, and this evening is dedicated to honoring and recognizing the contributions that you have made to the tradition of excellence at Wayne Hills High School. The Board of Education and the administration are delighted with your successes and are happy to share with you tonight your outstanding moments in time with you. Remember, and I don't often quote her, but Oprah Winfrey had something the other day that I thought was very appropriate. As you go forward, you can have it all. You just can't have it all at once. Everyone wants to ride with you in the limo, but what you need is someone who will take the bus with you when the limo breaks down. Those are your real friends, and the true bus riders are your parents and family that are here in this audience. Congratulations on your amazing achievements. Keep striving to be the best by doing your best. We expect great things from you. And I leave you with the words of Mark Twain. 20 years from now, you will be disappointed by the things you didn't do, more so than the ones that you did do. So throw off those things that bind you as you sail away from the safe harbor of Wayne Hills High School and your family and your friends. Catch the trade winds in your sail. Explore, dream, discover. But most of all, be true to yourself. And above everything else, please be happy. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Nusatelli. We'll be beginning the community scholarships, and we will have representatives from various groups and organizations in the community approaching the podium, and they will be presenting these awards. So when I do call up the organization, I ask that the representatives come up. The Americanism Award, the Jewish War Veterans Ladies Auxiliary, Mrs. Marjorie Katz, who's the president, will be presenting. Mrs. Katz. Yes. Gabriella, right.
Miss Gabriella Carafel. Congratulations from the Jewish War Vets. We're so proud that you showed what your Americanism was. I hope this helps you with a little bit with some books. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, our second award tonight will be the Jewish War Veterans. Mr. Mort Millinger will present.
Congratulations, students, graduates, good-looking group. Better than I see at most of the high schools that I make presentations. Don't get swell heads now. Will Henry Wolf's grandson please come forward? Shane, it is my pleasure to award you first prize in the Dr. Philip Shapiro, Leo A. Siegel, Education Grant from the Jewish War Veterans Department, New Jersey. Here is a check for $2,000. And Here is an application for our national scholarship. If you'll fill that out and send it to me, maybe we can get you some more money. Thank you very much.
Our business partner, BAE Systems, this award will be presented by Mr. Edward Zambrano.
Good evening and welcome. I get the honor of presenting several scholarships this evening for the community donors who were not able to be here this evening. They have, however, expressed their congratulations and wish everyone continued success. Each recipient is truly deserving. I applaud their accomplishments. On behalf of BAE Systems, our corporate partner, I am pleased to present the scholarship to Mohit Bahel and Jerrica Echo.
Mr. and Mrs. Herb Goldstein will now present the Barry Goldstein Memorial Scholarship.
First, I'd like to congratulate all of the young men and women for their achievements this year and wish you all the best for the future. I want to tell you a little something about our scholarship. Our daughter, Barry, was a student here at Wayne Hills from 1999 until 2003. She was in the special education class, and I think Wayne Hills was the happiest time of her life. She passed away in April of 2005, so to honor her memory, we thought, what better application could we put out there than a scholarship to the school that she loved so much. This year, the scholarship goes to Miss Rose Yu. Congratulations. Thank you.
The Bethany Korean Community Scholarship will be presented by Dr. E. Young Lee.
Good evening, everybody. On behalf of Bethany Korean Church in Wayne, I'm honored to present this award to a very special person, Christina Mendoza.
Boston Scientific Corporation Scholarship. Mr. Patrick Walls, Vice President, in his place will be Mr. Edward Zambrano.
On behalf of Boston Scientific Corporation, I am pleased to present the scholarship to Vanessa Roman. On behalf of BP Lubricants USA Incorporated, I am pleased to present two scholarships, one to David Freifeld, the other Talia Rapp.
Congratulations.
house. On behalf of Breyer Animal Studies, I am pleased to present a scholarship to Kristen Schweigart.
The Childhood Cancer Society Scholarship Fund actually is being presented by one of our own students who has formed this organization and has raised tens of thousands of dollars to fight childhood cancer. We're very proud to present this presenter, Mr. Tommy Head.
Thank you. The criteria for this scholarship was, I tried to broaden our horizons a little bit. Instead of just cancer, it was blood-related disorders, a student who demonstrated good leadership qualities, maintained a 3.5 or better, I believe. So I'd like to call up this student who overcame great boundaries, Jonathan Mariardi. Your check for $1,000.
Thank you. The Caldwell Bankers Associates of Wayne scholarship will be presented by Ms. Patty Tahan, the manager. Sorry. Thank you for coming.
Good evening, everyone, and congratulations, especially to these wonderful, beautiful students and their families. I'm the manager of Caldwell Banker here in Wayne, and we are very proud to be involved with our community. This is an annual scholarship, and we give both high schools. The beauty about it is that the associates put money from each transaction into our fund to enable our youth to go on to make their lives a little bit easier. So I commend each and every one of you for putting up with our craziness of being parents and community people in the town, and I hope to see you all on Wayne Day. Our scholarship tonight goes to Manish Desai. Congratulations, honey. God bless you, sweetheart. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Tahan. The Danny Affolito Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Joseph T. Affolito, Jr.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Joe Affolito, Jr. Congratulations, students, on your achievements. We're here tonight to present the Danny Affolito Memorial Scholarship Award. My brother Danny was a student at Wayne Hills High School. He graduated in 1987. He was tragically killed in the events surrounding September 11th. What better way in his honor that we thought as a family, my mom's here, to raise money for the sole purpose of giving away scholarships. We've expanded it over the years. We used to give away one scholarship to a student here at Wayne Hills High School in his honor. We've expanded it to two students. We choose a young man and a young lady each year that met the criteria that was set forth by the trustees of the fund, and this year's award. There's two awards, each for $2,500. The young man's name is Spencer Fertig. Congratulations. And the young lady, I hope I get this pronounced right, Susan Luo. Is that right? Congratulations, Susan. Thank you.
The David Feit Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Mrs. Frances Feit.
Good evening. Good evening, everybody. The David Feit Memorial Foundation was established in 2002 by some of my late husband's wonderful friends. Its mission statement is to donate funds that will benefit youth activities, a very fitting tribute to David's memory since he loved being around children. Whether it was coaching a team or treating them in his office, he very rarely said no to any request to support a local youth activity. David graduated from Wayne Valley in 1976, attended Muhlenberg College, and then went on to graduate from the University of Pennsylvania School of Dental Medicine. He returned to Wayne to practice dentistry with his father and did so until his passing in 2002. The DFM Foundation Scholarship is presented to a senior who has an interest in pursuing a career in a health-related field and whose academic accomplishments mirror those of David's. Congratulations to all of tonight's winners. It's with great pride that I present this $2,500 David Feit Memorial Scholarship to Jessica Chowdhury.
The Wayne's Lion Club Edward A. Otto Memorial Scholarship will be presented by someone who is not a stranger at all at Wayne Hills. In fact, one of the original plankers. A planker is a person who was here when the school opened, and he retired last year, but decided when we had to leave to come back, and he's teaching with us, and we're very proud that he is. So for the Wayne's Lions Club, Mr. Al Ruffini.
Thank you very much, and congratulations, soon to be freshman again, class of 07, and you'll love it. The Wayne Lions Club this year has given away $14,000 in scholarships to the four schools across this town of Wayne. That's Say County Tech, that's DePaul, Wayne Valley, and Wayne Hills. And part of that generosity was made by Kenneth Otto, who generously donated funds. One in memory of his wife, which I will read to you. The scholarships go for service and scholarship, both. His wife, which he misses dearly. Her gift to her family and all those who knew her was her belief that humor, more than anything else, lightens the burdens of life, reduces conflicts, and creates an atmosphere for love and harmony. Humor was not just something Veronica believed in, but instinctively practiced every day of her life. She lived her life following the principle that she was not better than anyone else, but that nobody was better than she. Always keep your head held high, but if someone was needed it to help them keep their head high as well. And she never, never had a bad word to say about anyone. There is always some good in everyone, but with some it may take time to find, but it's there. Veronica would always take the time to enjoy the little things of life, the first flower to pop up in spring, the sun glittering off ice-covered tree branches after an ice storm, a wonderful sunset. There are so many everyday things of beauty all around us. Most of it is just some of them. Veronica took the time to enjoy these things. Too bad for all of us, her life was so short. She was only 54 when God took her. This award in her name is something Veronica would be proud to be part of. And it goes to a young lady who has given service from cleaning the beaches of Asbury Park to sponsoring Christmas parties at the Foundation for the Handicap, to opening the only camp for blind children in the state of New Jersey. I am proud to award this $5,000 scholarship to Anna D'Alessandro. The next one is a fellow Lion for Ed Otto, Ken's brother. Ed had done so much in raising monies for the needy in this town, the visually handicapped, for scholarships. Ed was a golfer and organized the Wayne Lions golf tournament. I dearly miss him. He was a friend of mine. His children went to this school, and his brother is given a scholarship in his honor. And by the way, the Lions will be at Wayne Day and selling some of the best sausages and peppers you're ever going to eat. So please visit us, because it goes to them. This $2,500 scholarship goes to another person whom I shall dearly miss in the Ecology Club and the Leo Club, which are the Young Lions. She also served. Every time I needed somebody there, she was there. And one time when we only had about five or six people, she was there. This $2,500 scholarship goes to Shailene Decker.
Gordon Johnston Memorial Fund from the Wayne Education Association will be presented by Mr. Edward Zambrano.
I am pleased to present the Gordon Johnston Memorial Scholarship to Alexandra Galkin. On behalf of the Junior Women's Club of Wayne, I am pleased to present their scholarship to Sarah Frankis.
Marilyn Mezzi Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Ernest F. Mezzi. When you hear the voice, you will recognize that he is our football announcer at Patriot Stadium. He also does our winter sports in the Gifford Gym. Thank you for all the support that you give the school.
I got to be real honest with you. I'm very nervous when I have to do this each year, and I just figured it out tonight. The reason is because when I do the football games, everybody is looking in the other direction. So if you'd all kindly just turn around and look towards the football field, I'll feel more comfortable. It's been almost 4 years since Marilyn passed away. This year's generation of seniors, therefore, probably does not know of her. And yet it's my hope to continue this scholarship for years to come and to keep her memory alive here at Wayne Hills High School. She came into my life some 35 years ago, and in attempting to deal with her loss, to comprehend it, I've come to the conclusion that Marilyn was a gift from a higher power to me, on loan to me, so to speak. My daughter Lauren and son Michael, both graduates of Wayne Hills, had the gift of their mom for 18 and 21 years, respectively. Not really a long time. Indeed, we never know when those loans or gifts are going to be called in. In dealing with the illness which she endured for most of her life, or actually half of her life, Marilyn was somehow able to go outside of herself. It was her way of dealing with it. She gave of herself to family and friends alike, and she had quite a sense of humor, as many teachers here at Wayne Hills, I'm sure, can attest. And so with that sense of giving, we honor her memory with the awarding of this year's scholarship for the fourth consecutive year. And this year's recipient studied Spanish for 4 years, will attend the University of Maryland, majoring in business and accounting. He was student council class representative, played baseball, my sport, and ice hockey for 4 years. The 2007 Marilyn Mezzi Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Eric White.
Thank you, Eric. The Michael J. Loffredo Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Edward Zambrano.
In memory of Michael J. Loffredo, on behalf of his parents, I am pleased to present the Michael J. Loffredo Scholarship to Samantha Marasco.
Mrs. Joan Riley will now present the Pines Lake Women's Club Achievement Awards. Thank you, Mrs. Riley. Thank you for coming.
Good evening. May I add my congratulations to all these talented young people sitting on the stage tonight. And congratulations to you, the parents, who have guided them and now share in their reflected glory. A little bit. The Pines Lake Women's Club has supported the youth of our community for the past 50 years and has given out awards. And tonight, I have the pleasure of presenting our 2007 Achievement Awards to two young women who are destined to succeed. May I present the awards to Caitlin Chioka and Kelsey Adams. Caitlin, you're welcome. Kelsey, congratulations. Thank you.
The Riverview Garden Club of Greater Wayne Scholarship, Mrs. Kathleen Shepherd.
The Riverview Garden Club has been in existence since 1958. Besides digging gardens and maintaining the gardens in the township, we also award two scholarships, one at Valley and one at Hills. The one here will be awarded to a student who is very conscientious and wishes to pursue the field of science, particularly the medical field, attending Lehigh University. This award will go to Jocelyn Joseph.
The St. Gobain Performance Plastic Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Bill Morrow, the plant manager. In his place, Mr. Edward Zambrano, could you do the honors? I'm sorry about that. I saw you sit down, but I would have done it myself.
That's okay. On behalf of St. Gobain Performance Plastic, I'm pleased to present this scholarship to Jason Kestacher. The check is in the mail.
The Stephen R. Faber Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Ronald Faber.
Although I attended this ceremony in 2002 when my daughter Valerie graduated and received the scholarship, I confess I wasn't paying attention. So I promise I will do better next year. This is the first year of the Stephen R. Fava Memorial Scholarship. Some of you may know Stephen. He graduated Wayne Hills in 2006, was an honor student, member of the National Honor Society, played football for Wayne Hills for 3 years, although you wouldn't know him from that because he really wasn't much of an athlete. But no quit, 100% effort. He attended University of South Carolina last September as a biomedical engineering major, was a straight-A student until we tragically lost him 4 months ago today on February 4th. This scholarship, we hope in some way, will keep his memory and spirit alive and help the fine young people I see here tonight continue with their education. We have two scholarships we're giving out, one to a young man and one to a young lady. The young man scholarship is being won by a senior who's a sociology major. He'll be attending New York University. He has served as a volleyball captain for the last 3 years and is treasurer of the National Honor Society, Justin Choi. Would you please come up? And the scholarship to the young lady is being presented to a mathematics major, which was Stephen's major. I wasn't able to help him with his math homework from the sixth grade on. She'll be attending the College of New Jersey, student leader at grades 9 through 12 in Bethany Church, and the education committee member of the Latin Club, Brittany Oldwortel. Brittany? Thank you.
The Wayne Council PTO Browsing Shop Academic Scholarship will be presented by our Board of Education member, Mrs. Karen Hershaft. She is the director of the Browsing Shop.
Good evening, everyone. It is my pleasure to present the following four students with Wayne Council PTO Browsing Shop Scholarships. Our first recipient is Evan Klein. Congratulations. Our second recipient is Ricky Katz. Congratulations. Third is Christina Davies. Hope I said your name right. Congratulations. And our last but not least is Aaron Grober. Congratulations. Congratulations to all of tonight's recipients and to the parents and the class of 2007.
The Wayne Council PTO Commemorative Scholarship will be presented by Mrs. Lisa Akampora. Okay. She is the PTO Council Secretary.
Thank you. It is my honor to award the Commemorative Scholarship to Sarah O'Connor. My second commemorative scholarship, Christine Hannigan.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I have two more under leadership, Melissa Lash. Cynthia Easter. Under community, I have Janine Mascari. The final PTO Council scholarship for community goes to Karen Thomas. Thank you.
The Wayne Council PTO Special Achievement Award, the PTO Special Achievement Scholarship, and the PTO Cultural Workshop Visual Arts, and the PTO Cultural Workshop Science and Technology will be presented by Mrs. Joyce Duncan, the PTO Council President. Thank you for coming, Joyce. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for being here, and thank you for making this possible. I just would like to say a few words about our PTO. We have a lot of hardworking people, as you well know, and our funds are raised primarily through our browsing shop, our PTO browsing shop in Hamburg Turnpike, and our children's cultural workshop, which is held at Schuyler Colfax Middle School on Saturday mornings, and also through our local PTO chapters. This year, we are proud to say that we are giving out a total of almost $33,000 to the students at both schools. And to all of you, we congratulate you on all your achievements and your awards, and may the future bring you continued academic success, happiness, and the best of your dreams. The first special achievement award goes to Timothy Joseph. We have another achievement scholarship. This one goes to Michael Massoud. We have two cultural workshop awards for visual arts. Our first recipient is Rachel Shim. The next award for visual arts from our cultural workshop is for Jessica Lutzka.
Congratulations. I hope you'll say your name correctly. The next one's not here. I just mentioned it.
We have an award also from our cultural workshop for science and technology, and the recipient is not here this evening, but we'd like to congratulate Sarah Carlock. We have three more awards from our cultural workshop, and these are under our education category. The first award goes to Constance Ollis.
Congratulations.
Our next award for education is for Tara Shoebridge. And last but not least, of course, our last education award goes to Nicole Van Clive. Congratulations. Congratulations. Okay. Congratulations again to all of you.
The Wayne Education Association Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Edward Zambrano.
On behalf of the Wayne Education Association, I am pleased to present the scholarship this year to Gabriel Seidman.
PTO scholarship. This money is raised by our PTO, and I want to personally thank both Mrs. Helen Kluger, our current president, and our president-elect, Mrs. Renee Dent. They will do the presentations.
On behalf of Wayne Hills PTO, Mrs. Dent and I are extremely pleased to offer to these students 10 $500 scholarships. Kristen Anderson.
Congratulations. Amanda DeMore.
Matthew Dubow. Jamie Flaccovento. Joseph Giovannoni. Holly Grebe. Shane Colpon. Evan Mangiardo. Joanna Schrank. And Danielle Turigano. Again, thank you, and congratulations to all the parents and the class of 2007 and all the scholarship winners. Did great.
The Wayne PBA Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Wayne Hill's own SRO, Detective Chris Wittig.
It's my honor on behalf of Wayne PBA Local 136 to present scholarships to two outstanding students. The first recipient is Mina Wang. And the second recipient is Richard Serra. Thank you.
the Wayne School Retiree Scholarship. The Wayne Hills retirees are very active. They have monthly lunches. They're very supportive of our school, very supportive of our students. Someone very special to me, because when I broke into Wayne and Skylar Colfax, she was the secretary in the guidance department, and I must say, did a fine job running that department. So I'd like to introduce Mrs. Hildegard Robbins.
This is from all the Wayne retirees that work for the Wayne Board of Education, and I'd like to present this to Rebecca Hahn. Congratulations.
The WNBC TV Broadcasting Scholarship will be presented by Mr. Edward Zimbrano.
On behalf of WNBC Broadcasting, I am pleased to present this scholarship to Nicole Locantor.
Now we'll be getting into the national and state scholarship recipients. In the 2005 PSAT, about 1.4 million students were tested. Out of those 1.4 million, 8,200 students received various types of recognition. Our National Merit Scholarship recipients, there were 2,500 National Merit Scholarship, 2,500 received it, it's a $2,500 scholarship. They were two of 15,000 finalists, and they were David Freifeld, and Evan Klein. The National American University Scholarship, there were 4,600 merit scholarships awarded nationally. Our recipient was Lara Akel. The National Merit Scholarship finalist, this would represent less than 1% of the test takers, and they were Laura Akel, Spencer Fertig, David Freifeld, Rebecca Hahn, Jason Kestiger, Evan Klein, Susan Law, and And the next person was someone, the last time I saw him, he was performing in The Wizard of Oz, made us all proud, Gabriel Seidman. Top 5% of over 1.4 million tested in the 2005 PSAT are the National Merit Commended students. And among them are Kelsey Adams, Regina Bauernschmidt, Gabrielle Carifer, Sarah Carlock, and is not with us, Caitlin Kiyoka, Robert DiLorenzo, who's not here. Okay. Alexandra Galkin. Joseph Givanoni. And because he was one of the big three in the play that helped Dorothy, Aaron Grober. Richard Katz.
Yeah, right.
Congratulations. Good job. Oh, I got the wrong one. All right, well, we're going to have to change these. Shane Colpan. The third of the threesome that helped Dorothy, Andrew Minster. Congratulations. Rachel Shim. Karen Thomas. And Rose Yu. Out of 3,400 students, 3,400 students out of 175,000 qualified for the National Hispanic Recognition Scholar. We have a recipient at Wayne Hills, and it's Andrew Minster. Congratulations. We have a special scholarship, and this is from a Novartis National Merit Scholarship. And this is sponsored by Novartis for outstanding students meeting criteria set forth by the sponsor. And our recipient was Gabrielle Califer. Very nice. Okay. Mrs. Marr will now present the Edward J. Blaustein Distinguished Scholars.
Thank you. Edward J. Blaustein Distinguished Scholars rank in the top 10% of their class with an SAT score over 1,260. Dr. Edward J. Blaustein, for whom this Distinguished Scholar Award is named, was the 17th president of Rutgers. He served as president of Rutgers for more than 18 years and directed the university's development into one of America's premier public institutions for undergraduate and graduate education. He was deeply committed to the central role of undergraduate education within a research university, the university's responsibility to encourage participation in public service, and to the value of merit-based scholarships to recognize, support, and promote academic excellence. Our first recipient is Svetlana Abramsky. Kelsey Adams. Lara Akel. Jordan Cassisi. Gabriel Califra. Caitlin Kiyoka. Jessica Chowdhury. Anna D'Alessandro. Christine Davies. Monish Desai. Jerrica Echo. Spencer Fertig. David Freifeld. Alexandra Galkin. Joseph Giovannoni. Rebecca Hahn. Richard Katz. Jason Kestacher. Congratulations. Evan Klein. Congratulations, Evan. Shane Colpon. Melissa Lash. Nicole Locantour. Susan Law. Andrew Minster. Evan Mongiardo. Eric Nielsen. Gabriel Seidman. Rachel Shim. Robert Taylor. Congratulations, Robert. Rose Yu. And now we will be taking a short intermission of about 10 minutes. You are welcome to go across the hall for something cool to drink and refreshments. In the commons.
Mixed up. Worse, I could have been an air traffic controller.
Can I just blow my nose back here for a second?
Yes, you may.
I think we're basically all in. Why don't we try to get started?
Okay, please find your seats. We're going to begin the second part of our program.
When I'm done.
Yeah.
Right. Thank you. The second part of our program constitutes the Academic Recognition Awards. And these are very special awards because they are selected by our staff for students who not only showed interest but excelled in various subjects, various departments, various clubs, activities. These were truly our students recognized as the leaders in these respective clubs, activities, and academics. I attended a couple of college graduations this spring, and I heard one phrase, I may use it in the graduation speech, so don't pay attention to this, but that the staff is the lifeblood of the school. And I can't say enough about the staff at Wayne Hills High School. You will see so many teachers out tonight, as you will at all of our events, giving that extra time and that extra care so that students get that benefit. And I can't thank our staff enough. I can't thank our department chairs enough, because we certainly have a caring community. And I think that's what distinguishes Wayne Hills from many other high schools, is the care that we put in and the quality of the people that we have working with our students. So I'm going to begin this with two very important academic awards. Mrs. Joyce Duncan, the PTO Council President, will present the valedictorian and the salutatorian award at this time. Mrs. Duncan.
Hello again. I just want to tell you all that you're just awesome. You're very impressive and inspiring. And I'm going to go home and tell my oldest child, my oldest of three, who's just starting high school next year, all about you. So thank you. On behalf of the Wayne Council of PTOs, it is my pleasure and honor to present the valedictorian and salutatorian plaques tonight here at Wayne Hills High School. The valedictorian plaque is awarded to an exceptional student who will be studying at Princeton University and studying operations, research, and financial engineering. I'm not even sure what that is. That exceptional student is David Freifeld. I am very happy to present the salutatorian plaque, to another exceptional student. who will be studying biology and pre-med at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. And that wonderful student is Rose Yu.
Both David and Rose, we shared breakfast last, actually Friday morning at the Brownstone for all the valedictorians and salutatorians in the county. And I have to say that we were very well represented, and I'm proud of both of them for their achievements this year and the 4 years they were here at Wayne Hills. So congratulations. The Principal's Leadership Award is an award of a person who, who really seems to be all over all the time, demonstrates a great deal of character, leadership potential, basically the whole leadership package. This is always a very tough decision, especially with such a gifted class. But this year's Principal Leadership Award does go to Spencer Ferdy. The Character Award, that's the person that you want doing your taxes, doing your, no, I'm kidding. The person that you would always know that would act the same regardless of where he was or what he was doing. And it is a young man this year, and I'm very proud to present it to Jason Kestecher. The Humanitarian Award, and I think that this person will continue what he has done and what he is doing at this point. I think we'll be hearing a lot about him in the future as a humanitarian, a philanthropist maybe, like Andrew Carnegie. But I'd like to congratulate Tommy Head. If we had to epitomize the student at Wayne Hills that would best represent the Patriots, probably in all aspects, the Patriots Spirit and Pride Award to a person that's really distinguished herself this year, it's Nicole Lockentour. Also in the Patriot Spirit and Pride Award, we have a male counterpart, a person that is also very popular but is just doing so many things. And I think of the Jazz in the Commons, I think of all the productions, I think of just seeing him all over and really having a positive attitude and just being a great representative of Wayne Hills, and that's Gabe Seidman. Yeah. We will now be going into our departmental awards, and the department chairs and staff will be taking it over at this time. And we're going to begin with the Applied Technology Department Awards. Ms. Judy Failey will begin this program.
The first award we have is for business education. Mrs. McLean was going to be here tonight to present this award, but she wasn't able to attend at the last minute, so she asked me to read this for her. It is the privilege and pleasure of the Business Education Department to have had such a wonderful student and person in our classes. She exemplifies the meaning of a leader. She is not only an intelligent young lady, but she is also respectful to her teachers and peers, creative in her thinking, and enthusiastic about her work. Donald Trump had better watch out. Congratulations to Talia Rapp for receiving the Business Education Award. Okay. Mrs. Ure is going to present the award for Family and Consumer Science.
Good evening, everybody. By aiming higher, they found each day holds new opportunities. By striving harder, they realize there's no limit to what they can achieve. The awards for excellence in the Family and Consumer Science Department are being awarded to three young ladies this year who have been outstanding in all areas of our curriculum. The first young lady that I would like to recognize is Ms. Lauren Tett. She's not here this evening. Second young lady is Larissa Verhagen. And the third young lady is Miss Rachel Cass. Thank you.
Who's next? Judy?
Okay. Ms. Failey will now present the Future Teachers Academy Award.
The Future Teacher Academy is an example of a small learning community within the larger high school setting. It was established to provide in-depth experiences to students considering a career in education. In its freshman year, the Academy is currently serving close to 60 students, sophomores through seniors, from both Wayne Valley and Wayne Hills. As a supervisor of the Academy, it gives me great pleasure to recognize the following seniors who chose to devote their precious time this year and their energy during their busy high school schedules to explore their career interests in education. And our first award goes to Michael DiChiara. Congratulations. Danielle Hulbert. Justin Licio. And Danielle Roger. And now Mr. Hoogstraat will present our TV production awards.
This year we're going to give out two awards for the TV production award. Both did outstanding jobs this year. The first has been a staple in our program for 4 years, showing great leadership throughout her 4 years here. Mr. Castagna, who taught two of this year's TV1 classes, stated to me on many occasions how professional she had been. She's the first sibling of a former TV award winner, her sister having won in 2004, I believe. She will be heading off to Penn State in the fall. She's Kristen Anderson. Secondly, second person has been an extremely valuable asset, not only to the class, but in the video club as well. From announcing football games to directing band concerts, This senior, has really left his mark on this program. He will also be going on to Penn State to study communications in the fall. He is Matt DeBow. Yeah. Judy Failey one more time.
The Marion Pitt Award for Technology Education is given to a student or students who have displayed interest, enthusiasm, and success in a variety of classes offered by the department. In addition to these characteristics, this year's seniors are also recognized for their creative talents and leadership skills. Congratulations and best wishes to Jimmy Mandera. And Ryan Scullion. Mr. Ryerson is going to present the awards for your book.
Congratulations, class of 2007, parents and friends, welcome. My name is Gordon Ryerson, and I'm the yearbook advisor for Heritage 2007, and I'm very proud to say that because we have an excellent and a wonderful yearbook that you'll be seeing shortly. So, bank congratulations to all editors, staff members, and to the entire class. This year, we honor a number of editors who have spent a lot of time working on the yearbook, and I'm quite proud of them, and we're here tonight to celebrate and award them their honors. The first award goes to Danielle Polidor. Secondly, and since we don't want to give her any heart palpitations because I made her wait when she was selected as editor, Vanessa Roman. Thirdly, Caitlin Kiyoka. Fourth is Sarah Francis. Thank you, Sarah. Good job. And fifth is Cindy Esser.
Good evening. The Fred P. Sharkey Award is named after a very, very beloved member and chairman of the English department. The award is given to that student who the department feels shows the same love of the written word that Fred did. And this year, the award goes to Spencer Fertig. For the past 4 years, our students have been participating in the Wordmaster Challenge. The Wordmaster Challenge is a national competition. This year, and basically what the students are asked to do is read a passage and answer questions which require attention to reading and a sensitivity to language. Students are asked to recognize the emotional and or rational logic of a piece of writing and to notice ways in which the writer shapes and shades his meaning. This year, our seniors placed 9th in the nation. And much of this is due to the two people, Ricky Katz, and Laura Kell. And The Lantern, our literary magazine, gives a special award to that student who contributed, I can't say most because everyone who works on the Lantern is contributing, but to that student who really showed an artistic flair. And the young man who won the award this year is not with us tonight, Brad Morris. Thank you. I'm sorry, Mr. Zambrano is coming up to do the math awards.
Someone during the intermission asked me what I did in my spare time. I couldn't remember. Each year, many talented students select course offerings within the mathematics department in order to expand their knowledge base, challenge their abilities, and prepare for rigorous expectations set before them as they continue their studies at the university level. This year's Mathematics Award recipient has demonstrated the natural aptitude, enjoyment of challenge, and perseverance to test his abilities. Every teacher has commented on his outstanding performance and enjoyment for learning. In his sophomore year, he coordinated the effort to establish our mathematics club. This year's recipient will continue his studies in the fall at Princeton University, majoring in operations research and financial engineering. It is with great pleasure that I present this award to David Freifeld. The Computer Science Award recipient began his studies in our department as a freshman taking C++. Sophomore and junior years, he continued to explore the field, completing the Oracle Academy courses 1 and 2, in which he gained proficiency in data modeling, database programming in SQL, and developed proficiency in programming in Java. This year, he completed the Computer Science AB course and web development. He took the Advanced Placement Examination in May. To his credit, he has earned an A in each and every one of the courses he's undertaken. His intention is to continue studying computer science in the fall at the New Jersey Institute of Technology. It is with great pleasure that I present this award to Eric Nielsen. The Mathematics Competition Award is presented to a student who has participated in various contests offered within our department that are designed to challenge his ability to apply what he has learned. He has participated in the New Jersey Mathematics League, the American High School Invitational Mathematics Examination, American Mathematics Competition, and the Mega Moody Math Challenge. His performance during each of these competitions has demonstrated his exceptional ability and his competitive nature. Competitive, to say the least. In the fall, this year's recipient will continue his studies at the University of Pennsylvania, Wharton School of Business, majoring in finance. It is with great pleasure that I present this award to Ricky Katz. That's it for me this evening. I'd like to present Ms. Kara Cerfelli, our choral teacher, to present the choral award.
Good evening. This year's Choral Award is presented to two students who have shown extreme dedication and a love of singing. They have both been a choir member for 7 years, including their time in the Schuyler Colfax choirs. While they both enjoy time in the spotlight, their modesty makes them grounded and positive role models. Our first recipient has been an asset to our chamber choir for 3 years, and as the only male, has been very much adored by his classmates. He has often handled his own baritone voice part, showing that he has a skilled musical ear. This student works well as part of a team and is also an eloquent leader. He motivates the class with his humor, but also with his serious side. He entertained us as one of our MCs for the Wayne Hills Talent Show. This student is well-rounded, having also been involved in sports and other extracurricular activities, but always made time to volunteer for choir events. He will be greatly missed by me and by the other chamber choirs next year. At our recent spring concert, I called our second recipient my right-hand girl because of the myriad of roles she has served. Not only is she a strong part of our Soprano One section, but also a company, sometimes on the spur of the moment. She leads the choir in warm-ups and is quick to lend a helping hand with just about anything I need. The student is a skilled musician in all areas, from ear training to music theory to accompanying and dancing. You've seen her perform in all the Wayne Hills musicals, most recently as our Dorothy Gale from Kansas. She has become an expert on time management and prioritizing, having to juggle so many activities. Like our first recipient, she adds humor to our class but captivates their attention with her serious side. I will be lost without her next year. I wish both of them good wishes and more musical times in the years ahead. Congratulations to this year's Choral Award recipients, our Chamber Choir co-presidents, Alex Jones and Sarah O'Connor. And now I present Mr. Matt Paterno to present our Instrumental Music Awards.
Good evening. Our first award is our Outstanding Instrumental Music Award, and being an outstanding musician encompasses many characteristics, including technical ability, dedication, compassion, and a will to succeed. Tonight, we recognize a student who has brought honor to herself, our school, and the community of Wayne by earning positions in the North Jersey Area Band and the American Music Abroad 2006 Summer Tour. She has been a student leader in our band and helped to build the skills of our younger band members. The high standards she set for herself helped to inspire all of our musicians and raise the bar for our organization as a whole. The Outstanding Instrumental Music Award for 2007 is presented to Christina Barbera. The next award is our Walter F. Smith Award, and Coach John Wooden once said, a successful team involves many people who both understand and like the role they play on that team. For some people, the role includes their own performance and monitoring and helping others. The student we have chosen tonight has done equal parts during their time with our band. On behalf of Mr. Chuck Sastry and the Walter F. Smith Foundation, I am proud to present this year's award to Megan Rooney. Next is our Semper Fidelis Award, and the United States Marine Corps prides themselves on their principles of honor, courage, and commitment. Their Semper Fidelis Award for Musical Excellence seeks to recognize a student who upholds the same standard as a member of our school band. Semper Fidelis means always faithful, and this student has certainly been that. He has given everything he had to our program and asked very little in return. His commitment is unquestionable, and the courage he has shown through his effort as a leader is inspirational. In a way, he can't be with us here tonight because he's at fire school as a volunteer fireman upholding the very same principles. But I am very proud to present this year's Semper Fidelis Award to Matt Spadar. Our Wayne Hills Band Booster Scholarship is next, and the Wayne Hills Band Boosters are an incredibly enthusiastic and energetic group of parents who work for the betterment of our students' musical experience. Led by the president, Ms. Luann Barbera, they spend countless hours behind the scenes so that our students can enjoy the spotlight. The student they would like to honor this year has fulfilled the same role. She has led by example and taken charge of helping our students to reach their goals. Her sense of pride and commitment to the band is reminiscent of the parents themselves. On behalf of the Wayne Hills Band Boosters, I would very much like to present and proudly present their annual Senior Award Scholarship to Christine Hannigan. Thank you. Lastly, our John Philip Sousa Award is the highest award that we give out as an organization. The John Philip Sousa Award is known as the March King, but he also was credited with laying the foundation for what community and school bands have become. Since 1954, the John Philip Sousa Award has been given nationally to recognize thousands of outstanding students. This award has a special significance at Wayne Hills, as it is given to a senior who the students feel has done the most during their time here to build and advance our program. The student they chose this year has helped to advance all aspects of our program and has kept a watchful eye out for everyone. She has served as a drum major and officer and is an example of dedication and what can be accomplished when you apply it. On behalf of the 173 students of the Wayne Hills Band, it gives me great pleasure to present the 2007 John Philip Sousa Award to Abby Dubnoff. Good luck to the class of 2007, and I'd like to turn the microphone over to Mrs. Audrey Swin.
I would like to award and congratulate Kendall Carpenter and Rachel Shim for receiving the Fine Arts Award. Both are dedicated to art and creating art. They have been successful all 4 years. They've won numerous awards for our school and for themselves. And Kendall will be going to James Madison, and Rachel will be attending Cornell. And I'd like them to come up. I'd like to turn the program over to Mr. Mike Castagna.
Coach Vince Lombardi once said, "The quality of a person's life is in direct proportion to the commitment of excellence, regardless of their chosen field of endeavor." The students sitting on stage have each achieved a level of excellence in those endeavors, and I congratulate each and every one of you. This is sort of a bittersweet moment for me because this is the last time I'm standing on the stage after 35 years. I'm graduating along with them, so. From Vince Lombardi to Horace, no man ever reached excellence in any art or profession without having passed through the slow and painful process of study and preparation. The Margaret Erdman Award for the Fine and Performing Arts goes to just an individual. Tonight's recipient has consistently achieved excellence, not in just one area, but several. To paraphrase her college essay, she described herself as a triple threat, distinguishing herself as an actress, a singer, a dancer. And if this were not enough, she was also an accomplished musician playing the piano. Helen Keller once said, "When we do the best we can never know what miracle is wrought in our life or the life of another." Excuse me. Ladies and gentlemen, the Margaret Erdman Award for Fine and Performing Arts, along with a check for $600, goes to Sarah O'Connor. Oh, wait, don't leave. We also have a Mask and Gavel Award. The Mask and Gavel is a service organization where every morning students greet the rest of the school population with a good morning and please arise for the flag salute. Sarah's the unofficial president of the organization, and I appreciate everything she's done in keeping the program running. William Shakespeare said, "All the world is a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their entrances and exits, and one man in his time plays many parts." The Theater Arts Award for acting goes to an individual who's not only distinguished himself on our stage as an actor, but he's also worked diligently and quietly behind the scenes, serving as an assistant director, a production manager, a publicity manager, creator of programs, a miracle worker in his own right, as I asked him the night before to do something for me. And he's also my voice of unreason when I would become unreasonable with the cast. I read somewhere that he planned to be some kind of medical professional and still perform on Broadway at the same time. And I don't doubt that he will do this. The acting award goes to Aaron Grover. Okay, one more. Several things that a director never wants to hear from members of his technical crew are as follows. "Was I supposed to save the lighting cues to the disc before we shut the computer down? I think we just did the cues for Act 2 instead of Act 1. Is that okay? And I'm not sure when the next light cue is. Sarah O'Connor just dropped 3 pages of dialogue. You knew that was coming. The Technical Theater Award goes to an individual who, for the past 4 years, have worked behind the scenes for countless dance recitals, numerous elementary school concerts, school plays, musicals, assemblies, just about anything that required a microphone or light. Tonight's recipient, long after everybody else got to go home, stayed here, helped me focus lights. We programmed the Apple IIe computer. We even had to call last year's recipient of the award because we forgot the programming cues. Andrew's truly one of our unsung heroes, working very, very hard. He's never had a curtain call, and he's the person responsible for the magic of light on our stage. If there's any doubt about Andrew's commitment to excellence, I need to share something else with you, and I'm proud of this just because of my own interest in the field. Andrew told me about a month ago that he had soloed an aircraft. He now has 22 hours of experience to his time, and I want to share one thing with him. Andrew, any landing that you can walk away from is a good landing. Any landing you can use the airplane again is an excellent landing. The Technical Theater Award goes to Andrew Preha. This is Maureen Weir, Physical Education.
Thank you, Mr. Castagna, and congratulations to you as well. Congratulations to all the senior award recipients this evening. Excuse me. On behalf of the Wayne Hills High School Health and Physical Education Department, I am proud to announce the 2007 award recipients. These two students have a positive attitude towards health and wellness, and assist the faculty in promoting and modeling healthy lifestyle daily. This year's recipients are Kristen Anderson and Elliot Shaw. The Physical Education Department also recognizes a student who serves and assists the special physical education classes in skill development and positive role modeling. I don't believe our recipient is here this evening, but it's senior Lindsay Creek. Now I'd like to introduce Dr. Tony DeFina.
You should do the song. Good evening, everyone. I just want you to know that I wrote something very clever and very humorous until I bounced it off my peers, and unfortunately, I was the only one who thought it was clever and humorous, so I'm going to get right down to business. This year, the Science Award recipient is a personification of a quote from Aristotle, who I don't think graduated from Wayne Hills, but close. We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not a single act, but a habit. For this individual, the expectations and the attributes that list on a teacher recommendation form are very easily and unquestionably checked down the column with the heading that starts off with top 1% or best ever encountered in your career. But this young lady is quite much more than a best student cliche. Besides keeping me updated weekly on episodes of House, Grey's Anatomy, and Lost, she is warm, sociable, genuine, and has a humanistic touch that just makes her special and makes her our amazing Rose Yu. Yeah. And now Mr. Ben Grieco, Chair of World Studies.
Good evening. Tonight we are going to honor students in the four major languages that we teach here, French, Spanish, Latin, and Italian. And to begin, I'd like to invite Ms. Linda Greenberg up to do the French awards.
Good evening. Tonight I'm very proud to present the World Language Award for Achievement in French. I'm honored to have worked with these two young ladies this year. They have both excelled in French and have demonstrated a clear enthusiasm and love for learning the language and culture. Félicitations, congratulations, and je voudrais vous présenter Gabrielle Califre et Gabi Peller. And now I'd like to turn the program over to Mrs. Emerald.
Good evening. Once in a while, a student comes along that has a natural passion, not only for the Spanish language, but also for its culture. It has been a pleasure working with the three students being honored tonight. Our non-native speaker award tonight goes to Francesca Sanfilippo. And our native awards go to Katie Ash. And Christina Horta.
It's my pleasure to recognize the student for their achievement in Latin. And this year's recipient is Rose Yu. I also have the honor of doing the Italian award. We have two students who will be receiving awards for our Italian native. It's Karen Thomas. And the non-native recipient is Nicolette Grave. Nicolette at this time is not here. I also have an award for the outstanding achievement in world languages, and that goes to Francesca Sanfilippo, who is not here also. I also get the lucky opportunity to present the Social Studies Awards, and the Social Science Award tonight goes to Laura Akel. Yeah. The second award that I have for Social Studies is the Political Science Award. The purpose of the League of Women Voters Award is to promote political responsibility through informed and active participation of citizens in government and to act on selected governmental issues. This evening's recipient is Jason Kessinger. And last but not least, I have one more award to present, and that's the Model United Nations Award, and that also goes to Jason Kessinger. At this time, Mr. Keogh will come up and take over.
Good evening. Good evening and congratulations to each of you and to all of you. I'm Mr. Keogh, and Mr. Askley, our athletic director, was unable to attend this evening due to state and league athletic events and meetings. Therefore, I have the privilege of presenting a number of awards this evening. The athletic awards are given by the Wayne Hills coaching staff and administration to student athletes who have given their commitment over 4 years to the athletic programs at Wayne Hills and earned recognition at the league, at the county, and at the state level. This year's award winners are Kim Caltagirone and Ray Van Peenen. The New Jersey State Interscholastic Athletic Association Awards are given to male and female student athletes who embody sportsmanship ideals and the athletic accomplishments, as well as earning the scholastic achievement of being in the top 10% of their graduating class, as promoted by the state organization during their 4 years at Wayne Hills. And this year, we have three award winners. The first, Anna D'Alessandro. The second, Ricky Katz. The third, Evan Klein. The final awards I have the opportunity to present this evening are the Wendy's Heisman Awards. And these are given to one male and one female student. Since 1994, over 136,000 students have been recognized for this most prestigious high school honor, signifying excellence and determination in academics, athletics, and community and school involvement. This year's award winners are Nicole Locantor, and Jeffrey Przinski. Once again, congratulations to the students as well as to their parents and friends who are here this evening. Ms. Faley will now return to the podium.
Again, Mrs. McLean could not be here this evening to present the Future Business Leaders of America Award. The following young ladies have been the driving force behind all of the accomplishments in FBLA this year. Rebecca has won numerous first and second place awards during her four-year membership, more first than second. She has helped to keep the Wayne Hills High School FBLA as one of the most admired chapters in the state of New Jersey. Vavisha is quiet. She is a quiet storm. Vavisha works behind the scenes, keeping things in order. Her tireless effort is very much appreciated. They are both hardworking and wonderful to be around and to work with. They will be missed next year. Congratulations to Rebecca Hahn and Vavisha Patel for receiving the FBLA Leadership Awards. Mr. Hopper and Mr. Ryerson will come up for the senior awards, senior class.
I'm pretty certain that the three students that are getting this award tonight came to us already as leaders. I don't think that's something that they learned in high school. I think it was probably something they were born with. It's really been a privilege for Mr. Ryerson and I both to work with them for the 4 years they've been in high school and watch them kind of fine-tune that leadership skill. They've been class officers for 3 years. The list of things they've done as class officers would probably take us another hour, so I'm not even going to start on that. But they've really done well. It's been a real pleasure to work with them.
And on behalf of Mr. Hopper and myself, we want to thank all of the officers and reps over the years. Without your help, nothing would have been possible to accomplish. So we thank all of you. You really all deserve a round of applause. Tonight's first recipient is John Moriarty, our class president.
Johnny, great job, buddy.
Second is Sarah Francis. Thank you again, my dear. And third, Rebecca Hahn. Mrs. Patricia Ewer. Is she here tonight?
Good evening. The following young ladies have been involved in the Student Dance Association for the past 4 years and have been excellent examples of leadership and dedication. They are being awarded scholarships for their dedication and untiring effort to be at all the practices meetings and for giving more of themselves to make the 2007 SDA a successful production. On behalf of the Student Dance Association, I would like to congratulate Hannah Park, Danielle Markowitz, Kristen Schweigart, Nicole Forlenza, and Gemma Giovannis. I'd like to introduce Ms. Amaral and Mr. Terso.
Good evening. This is the time of year we like to take pause and reflect on the accomplishments of some very special young men and women. Young men and women who made a conscious decision to stand out from the crowd and represent all that is good here at Wayne Hills. Ms. Amaral and I co-advise the school's Student Council Executive Board, and this year the democratic process has once again provided for us the type of student leadership that has become the hallmark for success here at Hills. Ms. Amaral?
This year's Student Council Leadership Award goes to Spencer Fertig. And our Student Council scholarships go to Nicole Forlenza. Ricky Katz. Nicole Locantori. Vanessa Roman. And Spencer Fertig. And last but not least, Jeff Fruzinski. Next, Mrs. Allegri will be in honoring the Honor Society.
Hello, everyone. I'm so pleased to be here tonight as we honor the class of 2007. Specifically, I'm here this evening to present scholarship awards to two members of the National Honor Society. But before I present these awards, I would like to extend a heartfelt thank you to all the members of NHS, to the executive board and the officers who worked so hard this year to make all of our projects successful. This year's entire board was outstanding in its commitment to our projects. However, one brave soul had to deal with me first before every project, every board meeting, every anything. I told her in the beginning of the year that I needed to stay in close contact in case something needed to be done. She stopped by every day. Last year, she distinguished herself when a book collection for Mount St. Joseph's School produced hundreds of volumes that needed to be sorted, alphabetized, boxed, moved, and eventually transformed into a library for that school. She was amazing. This year, as NHS president, she graciously moved this organization forward with her commitment to making all of our projects 100% successful. I'd like to ask Talia Rapp to come forward. Talia, you join us here tonight because of the kind of person that you are, a leader, a woman of integrity, certainly a role model. I feel privileged to know you and to have worked with you this year. Congratulations on receiving the 2007 National Honor Society Leadership Award. The recipient of the next award was a little harder to choose because everyone who served on the board really worked in their appointed capacity. In the end, however, the organization of our citrus sale, the drive to extend ourselves with an international initiative to support Darfur by sponsoring a successful Wayne Hills dance, Dancing for Darfur, the hosting of our service auction, and the music and seating for 150 people at the Honor Society dinner were all handled with ease and style by Gabe Seidman, who is this year's recipient of the NHS Service Award. Congratulations, Gabe. And now I'd like to introduce Mr. Al Ruffini.
Greetings again, parents and friends and class of 2007. This award is given in memory of Tom Murray, who passed away this year, another lion, unsung hero to say the least, Navy Cross winner in the Pacific, a Marine, unsung hero of Wayne, a true giver. And so the Lions again will give a $1,000 scholarship to Olivia Christostom. Another of our heroes that lost his life defending our country, Cary Arthur, graduate of Wayne Hills, graduate of Annapolis, pilot, and lost his life in the skies over Libya. And in this honor, he was my ecology club president. This is an ecology club award. I don't know what I'm going to do without the bees, but she's always there when I need her. And another $1,000 scholarship to Samantha Beasley. And now, Miss Virginia Marr.
It's my great honor this evening to give the awards for our award-winning Patriot Press to Spencer Fertig, and Nicole Locantour. And our last award this evening is the Socialize Club Award. Mrs. Virginia Chiller was unable to be here. The winner is Loma Patel, who was also unable to be here, but congratulations to Loma.
Thank you, Mrs. Marr. For a group that is so engaging and so energetic, to sit for a little too long tonight, but to be so respectful of our speakers and our guests and of each other, and to just be so polite, I want to thank this group. That's the kind of leadership they've shown all year. And again, Thank you, seniors. And just to close, that the students here before you, they have distinguished themselves. The scholars, leaders, community contributors, artists, musicians, performers, and or athletes. Senior honorees, your recognition validates your stature as the most talented and promising students in your class. Congratulations and good night. Thank you very much.